The Australian Federal Police says it did not intend to radicalise a 13-year-old boy with autism during a counter-terrorism operation. A Victorian court last year found officers involved in an undercover probe groomed the teenager and increased his chances of offending. Community advocates are calling for a public inquiry.
Covert operations thrust into the spotlight.
Do you accept the magistrate's finding?
Listen, we acknowledge the magistrate's finding, we accept the finding, but...
So you're radicalising the kids?
Senator, that was not our intent and not our purpose.
It's what you did.
The AFP under fire over a case that began in late 2020 when it began investigating a 13-year-old boy with autism known by the pseudonym Thomas Carrick after reports he was viewing IS material on school computers. Months later, his parents went to Victoria Police with similar concerns, his father saying, "I was prepared to sacrifice my son for the safety of the Australian community." Thomas began rehabilitation. His psychologist told Victoria Police he used terrorism as a shock tactic, but had little knowledge of Islam and was reacting to social isolation. Still, the AFP's deputy commissioner ordered the probe continue without telling his family or psychologist.
It was obviously a decision I didn't take lightly, Senator. There was a set of exceptional circumstances.
According to court documents, undercover officers groomed Thomas, sending information about an 11-year-old who'd committed murder. "You'll make a good sniper or suicide bomber," one said. "Don't give up." Evidence showed Thomas was naive, asking, "Could I join the kids section of IS?"
The person was on the path to radicalisation long before we became involved, long before Victoria Police came involved.
It was the AFP who recommended he become a sniper and a suicide bomber.
Last October, a court ordered the case against him be dropped. Magistrate Fleming saying the AFP's conduct fell profoundly short of the minimum standards expected, adding Thomas's rehabilitation was thwarted.
Has anyone been held to account? Have you been held to account? Okay. Has the undercover operatives been held to account?
Community groups have described the case as egregious police misconduct and a betrayal of the family's trust in authority, with calls for the Labor government to launch a full public inquiry.
We believe there is an endemic problem within the police forces, particularly in relation to counter-terrorism cases.
SBS has contacted the government for comment. Sarah Tomevska, SBS World News.